Hello, Truvinians and friends. Welcome to our children's church. My name is Alicia Bell. I pray that all of you are having a great and blessed day. Let's have some church fun. Will you begin by singing our welcome song with me? Great! Let's begin and sing. Today's Bible adventure is called The First Sin. Can you say that with me? Ready? Begin. The First Sin. Good job. Let's join Emily and that beautiful star Shine in the Bible adventure. If you're ready, count down with, well, count up with me. One, two, three. Let's do that again. One, two, three.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
My name's Emily. Do you like going on adventures? I do too! I'm going on a Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to go with me. Woohoo! Great! Now, when's our friend Shine gonna show up? I know. Let's put on our adventure bags while we wait.
Wait a second. There's something in here.
Oh, it's my tablet. Look, I have a message from Shine. How do you make the right choice? That is a good question. Have you ever wondered that?
Whee!
Look, friends, it's Shine!
Hello, friends. Hiya, Emily. Are you all ready for today's Bible adventure?
Almost, Shine. First, I need to pack my adventure bag. Well, Shine, which of these picture passes will help me answer the question you sent?
I was reading the Bible today about how to make good choices. It gave me some ideas for what you should bring. Ready to guess?
Yes, I love your games. Friends, let's figure it out together. Shine, what's your first hint?
It's a part of your face, and you use it for talking.
The mouth? Jumpin' jelly beans, you've gotta be right. Your mouth is on your face so you can talk. Let's put it in our adventure bag.
Next, you have two of them on the sides of your head to listen with.
We pick the ear! I have two ears on the sides of my head. Let's pack the ear in our adventure bag.
Okay, one more thing. It's something you walk on and shows you the way to go.
I think you're right. Shine, we picked the path.
Yep, we walk on a path for all our Bible adventures. Put it in your adventure bag.
One, two, three! We've got them all! Let's zip our adventure bag together!
We'll find out how these picture passes remind us to make the right choice on our Bible adventure.
Now it's time to fly!
Whoa!
Thanks for helping me make the right choice in packing my bag, Shine. But what did you mean when you asked me the question, how do you make the right choice?
The right choice. You know, choosing God's way.
Well, how will an ear, a mouth, and a path help me choose God's way?
Well, let's look in the Bible to see.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
The first sin. That's from the book called Genesis.
Oh, that story happened a long, long, long time ago.
That's true, but it's still a real story about God's people. We can read it to learn how to live God's way and make the right choice.
The first man and woman, Adam and Eve, lived in a beautiful garden that God made for them. But Satan came as a crafty serpent and tempted Adam and Eve.
Did God say you must not eat the fruit from these trees? The serpent asked Eve.
Just the tree in the middle, Eve replied. If we eat from it, we'll die.
You won't die, said the serpent. There's a reason why God doesn't want you to eat from that tree. If you do, you'll be like him. You'll know what he knows.
Eve ate the fruit. She gave some to Adam, who was with her. He ate it too. And at once, they knew things they had never known before. One thing they knew was that they were naked. They sewed leaves together to cover themselves. They'd never felt fear or shame before, so they knew something was wrong. Adam, God called. Eve.
We're hiding, said Adam. We're naked.
You know that because you ate from the tree, God sighed.
Then Adam blamed Eve, and Eve blamed the serpent. God said,
Serpent, you must crawl on your belly. A woman's son will defeat you. Eve, childbirth will be painful. Adam, growing food will be difficult.
Then God made clothes for Adam and Eve, and sent them out of the garden. He put an angel with a flaming sword there so they could not return.
Smack and sugar snaps! God told Adam and Eve what they should do, and they didn't listen!
Yep, they made the wrong choice. They didn't ask God for help at all. They just did what they wanted to do.
Shine, I want to know how to make the right choice. How will such a sad story help me choose God's way? Wait a minute. Ask! That's what they didn't do. They didn't ask God.
Way to go, Emily. That's the answer to the question. How do you make the right choice?
I ask God. God helps me make the right choice.
Friends, we'll find out more about asking God on our Bible adventure. Don't forget to watch how the picture passes will help you along the way.
Will do. Say hi to Blinky for me. Come on, let's go.
Oh, I love this story. Oh, hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy. My friends and I are on a Bible adventure. We're trying to find the answer to the question, how do you make the right choice?
I ask God. God helps me make the right choice. I know lots of Bible verses about that.
We just watched a story about making the right choice from the Bible. Who was it about?
Adam and Eve? Oh, they made the wrong choice. They chose to do what they wanted to do instead of obeying what God said to do.
I don't want to be like that. Well, how do I know it's right?
The Bible says all you have to do is ask God. He will give you wisdom.
Is wisdom choosing what's right?
Wisdom is knowing what's right and doing it.
Oh, so if I don't know what to do, I can ask God. God will give me wisdom to make the right choice.
Exactly.
Huh.
Do you have a picture pass about asking God?
I think I do. Count with me, friends. One, two. Wait a minute. There's one missing. Friends, shake your adventure bags with me so we can get it out. That's better. Let's try again. One, two, three. They're all there.
So, what's on your face that you use for talking?
The mouth. I ask God with my mouth.
Yep, we can pray and ask God to help us make the right choice.
Guy, will you please teach us a Bible verse to help us remember?
Sure. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn the verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, watch first. James 1:5. If any of you need wisdom, ask God for it.
Guy, I think we're ready to try it.
All right, repeat after me. James 1:5.
James 1:5.
If any of you need wisdom.
If any of you need wisdom.
Ask God for it.
Ask God for it.
All right, now let's say the whole verse together.
Okay.
James 1:5. If any of you need wisdom, ask God for it.
Sunny sea monkeys, you always know the perfect verse. If I need wisdom to make the right choice, I ask God. Well, I'm off on my Bible adventure. Bye, Guy.
See you, Emily.
Come on.
Ooh.
Blinky, what were you doing in there?
Hi, Shine. I was, just smelling these bug bites. They're my favorite snack in the whole wide world, you know.
Yeah, I know. They are pretty yummy.
Yeah, well, Shine?
Yes, Blinky?
My mom said I'm not supposed to have any more bug bites today. I already had some for my snack.
Well, Blinky, you should probably stop flying inside the box and smelling them.
But she didn't say I couldn't smell them. And they smell so super-dee-duper good.
You know that once you smell them, you'll want to eat some even worse. Bug bites are so delicious.
You know what, Shine? I've got a good idea. What if I give you some bug bites? You know, just to be nice and all. And then you could share them with me.
Blinky, that's disobeying your mommy. That doesn't sound like the right choice at all.
Oh, Shine, I just really, really, really want to eat some more. I don't think my mom would mind if I shared them with you.
Friends, do you think it would be the right choice for us to eat just a few bug bites?
Shine, our friends say no, but I still can't decide what to do. Bug bites are super-dee-duper yummy, and my tummy is super-dee-duper hungry.
In the Bible story about Adam, Eve, and the first sin, Eve really wanted a bite of some special fruit from a special tree.
Did her mommy tell her not to eat it?
No, God told her not to eat it. But Eve didn't listen. She ate some and shared it with Adam. Then he ate it too.
They disobeyed God? That's never the right choice.
No, disobeying God is sin. If we want to make the right choice, we have to ask God what to do and choose to do what He says.
Shine.
Yes, Blinky?
I know the right choice to make. You want to know why?
Why, Blinky?
Because the Bible tells me what God says. And the Bible says to obey our parents. If my mommy says no, then I'll obey. I won't eat those bug bites, no matter how yummy they are.
Then let's shut this box and quit smelling these yummy bug bites. We'll go play instead.
Yeah, let's go. I feel so super-dee-duper better inside because I made the right choice. I feel even better than if I had more bug bites in my tummy.
What was that question again? Oh, yeah! How do you make the right choice? Friends, answer with me! I ask God! God helps me make the right choice.
Well, I ask God with my mouth, but that still leaves an ear and a path. Here I am on a path, and I have two ears, but how does that help me make the right choice?
That sounds like Mr. Music in a singing studio! I bet he has the perfect song to help us. Let's go find out!
That must be Emily! Come on in!
Hi, Mr. Music! My friends and I are on a Bible adventure!
So what's your Bible adventure about this time?
We're trying to find the answer to the question, how do you make the right choice? Friends, will you tell Mr. Music the answer?
That's right! I ask God. God helps me make the right choice.
Yeah! And Shine showed us a Bible story about the very first sin. You know, when Adam and Eve disobeyed God.
Whoa, sin is the wrong choice. But disobeying God is a choice we all make sometimes.
But I want to know how God can help me make the right choice instead. Our Bible verse is James 1:5. If any of you need wisdom, ask God for it. We ask God with our mouth.
But we still need to choose to listen to God and obey.
Cartwheeling kittens! That's it! I have a picture pass about listening. Count with me, friends. 1, 2, 3.
Friends, you have two of them on the sides of your head to listen with.
The ear!
That's right. Ears are for listening. We ask God and listen to what He says to do.
But wait, Mr. Music, in the Bible story, Adam and Eve listened to God with the ears on their head. It seems like God actually talked out loud to tell them the right choice.
Yeah, I think that is what the story shows us.
But I've never heard God with my ears. When I pray and ask God, I hear Him in my heart.
Me too. I feel God's voice inside me, telling me the right thing to do. And if I'm still not sure, I can read the Bible.
Yeah, that's it. I'll listen in my heart. I'll listen to the Bible. I'll listen when God tells me the right choice.
I even know a song about making the right choice.
I knew you would. That's why I love coming here.
Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
All right, I'm going to teach you your part. I'm going to sing God Helps Us to Make Right Choices, and you sing All You Gotta Do Is Pray.
Okay, friends, you sing with me.
Here we go. God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
Very good. God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
That was awesome. Let's sing it from the beginning, okay?
Okay.
Here we go. God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
There are days we all can be just like Adam and Eve. That's when Jesus helps me know the right way I should go. We sing! God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
When you don't know what to do, when you're feeling all confused, when you don't know His right way, ask Jesus when you pray. God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
We can listen to God's voice right before we make the choice. Then it's our job to obey and listen every day. Sing it out! God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
Again! God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
God helps us to make right choices.
All you gotta do is pray.
That was great! Now stand to your feet to worship God with singing, music, and dancing.
You made my ears.
One, two.
So I can listen. You made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see. You made my arms.
One, two.
So I can praise you. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. So I can follow you. You made my life.
friends.
Hi, Shine. My friends and I have been practicing our question and answer on our Bible adventure. Shine, you ask us the question, and friends, you say the answer with me.
Okay. How do you make the right choice?
I ask God. God helps me make the right choice.
Wait, and what about all those picture passes you took with you?
Count with me, friends. 1, 2, 3. First, we use our mouth to ask God for wisdom when we need to know what's right and wrong. That reminds me of our Bible verse, James 1:5. If any of you need wisdom, ask God for it.
Did you find out about the ear?
Yeah, when we ask God what to do, we listen and then we do it. We listen with our ears.
We can listen to God with our ears, and we can listen to Him with our hearts. We even hear what God wants us to do by listening to what the Bible has to say.
I learned all of that today. But, Shine, what about the path? What does that have to do with making the right choice?
God's way is the right way. When we choose the right way, we stay close to God. It's just like staying on the right path so we don't get lost.
Oh, I get it now. We find God's way by staying on His path. I want God's way to lead me wherever He wants me to go.
Me too. Let's start right now by praying to God and asking Him what He wants us to do.
Okay. Bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, please give us wisdom. Teach us how to listen to You and make the right choice. In Jesus' name, amen. We're bouncing babies. It's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Hi, children. I hope you enjoyed today's adventure. Let's review. We have the three picture passes. They are the mouth, the ear, and what's the third one? Yes, the path. Let's start with the first one, the mouth. We ask for wisdom from God with our what? Mouth, you have it. That's correct. Let's try number two, the ear. Now, we ask God what to do and we listen with our ears. Yes, we also listen with our heart. Yes, yes. Because we really don't hear God all the time with our ears, but we hear Him with our heart. Let's try or see if we can remember number three. The third picture puzzle is, you're right, the path. We find God's way by staying on the path. Now, how do we stay on the path? We remember to read God's word to stay on the path. God bless you, children. You've done an awesome job in review today. Parents, don't forget to like and share. Show our children that we care. God bless you and see you next week.